Hey, yo, everybody. So today we're going to have some real talk. Obviously, everybody knows what kind of situation we are in with this world and coronavirus, and that you don't get it from drinking too much beer. So obviously, there's so much chaos. I am not going to pretend that I'm a doctor. I have no training, neither does she.
No.
And so we're just going to come with our inputs and kind of, I guess, my prediction of, I guess, what I see happening with things. So, you know, first of all, is like the whole world is now experiencing, I guess, what we're experiencing. So everybody's getting a chance to be around family more. Everybody's detaching from work, and the whole busy stuff has kind of gone, what are you sneaking into? Has gone away from some people's lives. And while it might feel like there's an emptiness right now, hopefully what you're going to feel in a week or two is just like when you come back from vacation, to where you feel like, oh man, like, I guess I don't need to be doing all this. And I guess I've been doing too much of this and overextending myself. Well, you're going to get the same situation now. You're just going to do it maybe missing some money and missing some paychecks and some of those different things. So there's a lot of factors that play into this, but like one is appreciate the time with your family right now. Appreciate the time away from work, whether you're not getting paid or you are getting paid. Like, there is something to be said about just detaching from the day-to-day world. And I think what I've found already with a lot of clients and some who have lost jobs is like there's a lot of opportunity right now, and a lot of people need help, and a lot of people are needing, whether it's guidance, whether it's materials, whether it's supplies, whether it's something, but a lot of people need help. And so like right now is a time where you can come to somebody's rescue. It can build value in your life. It can give you purpose. But like there's a lot of other things that can be going on. The other side of it is I think a lot of our world and some of our day-to-day actions are going to change. And things like drive-thrus for coffee and fast food and some of these things and being the only option now, I think we're going to start to see as one of the only options once we come out of this side of it. And I think what we're going to start to see is like, you know, convenience type things and more interactions that don't require humans are going to take place. But also what I think is going to happen is while we're going to do more ordering online for Walmarts and more ordering online for our food, it's going to allow us more time to spend with your loves and the other people in your family. So I think we're going to start using this like time of inconvenience and almost starting to learn the conveniences of what we need to do to change our lives and change kind of our outlook on some different things. So that's the human component. On the fitness component, which is really what I want to talk to you about today, is I think this is going to be the separation of, just like it is with income, where there's high class, low class, no middle class anymore, I think we're going to experience the same thing with health. And here's the reason why. It's because I would say, like, when you call high class and like of the fitness world, that's people that are in great shape. That's a very, very small percentage. So let's say that's the 1%, just like it is with like your billionaires. And I think kind of your people that aren't in shape, that would be kind of whatever, like your, I hate using the word low class, but that's your non-working class, that's your government aid class, that's your whatever you want to call it. And then you have your middle class, your working class. Well, what happens is with that working class in the middle is you guys are so busy. You're busy with work, you're busy raising families, you're busy with your family, and you also have probably more obligations in your life than top half and bottom half of the classes have. So what's happening now is while we have this time off, all the excuses that you've used of, I'm too busy, I gotta go to kids' sports, I don't know what foods to eat, all these things that you've used as an excuse are gone now. So yes, you might not have a job, but you have time. And yes, maybe your kids don't eat the best food, but guess what? Now mom has a lot of time to spend with them to teach them better foods. You can also be active and exercise with your family. You can also now take away all the other excuses because the only thing left on the shelves is either the really bad stuff for you, which is all the boxed and prepackaged foods, and guess what? Tons of fruit and vegetables. So when you're looking at some of these different things, like you now go into the grocery store and you have a choice. Am I going with the red pill or the blue pill? Like it's the Matrix again. It's like, am I going to go down the path of like a healthier body, which again is your ultimate immunity when you come across a coronavirus, is just having good health, or you're going to go down the crappy path and you're going to look at this as like, oh, well, this is just easier and this lasts longer on my shelves and this is going to be non-perishable stuff. And more people are going to go towards the bad foods. And I see that as being almost as much of a discrepancy as it is now. Like you're going to have less people that are going to be the non-excuse people and just start working out and start eating healthier. But you're going to have a lot more of those people that drift to the other side. And so what you're going to find is this coronavirus, maybe you don't ever get affected by it, but you're going to be affected by it. Both maybe your wallet and your job and some of those different things, but your health. And so the biggest thing is like you can come out of this whole coronavirus 10, 15 pounds heavier in the course of a month, and you can blame it on corona. And nobody's going to blink an eye at it, and nobody's going to make you feel bad. They're gonna be like, oh yeah, I had the same thing too. And then there's gonna be those other people that come out of this and they see that this is opportunity, that this is freedom, that this is a chance to actually take control of your health, because it's the only thing really right now that we can control. We can't really decide what restaurants or bars or anything that we're going to, but like, you can choose to go outside and go walk today. You can drop on the ground and do crunches. You can do some sit-ups, or absandcore.com, absandcore.com. You just go to the 21-day program that we provided for free that gives you a meal plan, workouts, everything at home with no equipment, and you just get it done. So you really have a choice here. And while everybody feels like they're hopeless and helpless, like, you're not. It's just that you aren't going to work and you can't go to certain activities. But guess what you have more free time for? The number one thing that you've been making excuses for, and that's your health. So the biggest thing that we need to prioritize right now is you and your health, and you have the choice. When you go to the grocery store, go down the good side, not the bad side. When it comes to being lazy and watching another Netflix binge episode of whatever series you're watching, don't. Go outside and go be active. Put a podcast in your ears, and you can still be learning this whole time, but you're improving your health and you're bettering your life. So again, I think my prediction again is we're gonna see the disappearance of the middle class of health. Be the person that goes on the good side and ends up on the other side of this, on the successful and winning side. Not somebody who uses excuses, not somebody who plays as a victim, not somebody who's using everything else in the world as their excuse of why not. Be the person that says, hey, now's my time. And that's all it takes, is just one decision. So that's all I have. My wife has sat here answering messages and listening the whole time. Any other contributions to this?
Be safe and healthy, my friends.
Yeah, everyone's making sacrifices, guys. Your sacrifice could be to better yourself. See ya.